The answer is, one per card wouldn't be enough, and in any case, the number of cards is really irrelevant. What's important is the number of possible hands and the number of possible results we get for each type of hand, the rankings we get for each. So one per card doesn't make sense, 1,000 per card doesn't really help that much. Now we're talking. So here we say, at least expect to get 10 possible results for the least common rank. So least common is the straight flush, and if we expect to get 10 straight flushes, then probably we're not going to get exactly 10, but it's not going to be off by that much. If we expected only to get one straight flush, then maybe half the time we'd get 0 and half the time we'd get 2, and that would be off by a lot. That wouldn't be very good. But 10 seems about right. At least we're in the right ballpark. So if that's the right answer here, then what does that translate over here? Well, we can just look up the probability. We had that on the previous page. Look up the probability. It's about 1 in 60,000 or 66,000. And so if we have a little bit more than 10 of each, then that comes out to 700,000. And that's a lot less than 52 factorial, which is the total number of permutations of the hands. Actually, permutations isn't that important. A better number would be the total number of combinations. But even the total number of combinations is bigger than 700,000. So we're probably okay going here. And here's the code to calculate the hand percentages. So I give a default value for n, the number of deals that we're going to do, the default of 700,000, but you can put in as many as you want. And I should say, don't try to run this function here with 700,000 as the input, because it will take too long. It should take 20 or 30 seconds, and running on our servers, we don't let you run that long. So put in if you want to run it here, put in a smaller value for n, say 1,000 or so. Or if you want to run it on your own home machine, you're welcome to go ahead and do that. So we make up a vector of counts, which starts with no count for each of the 9 possibility. And then we go through the deals, and what I'm going to do is deal 10 hands, n over 10 times. And for each of those hands, I compute the ranking, and then increment the count for the ranking, and then I just print out the results. So when I hit run, here's what the results look like. And if I want to compare them to what we got from Wikipedia, I can go ahead and do that. So here you can see we have 2 columns. These are the results as computed by our random sampling, and these are the results as computed by exact math as shown in Wikipedia. And you can see they're pretty close in all cases.